السلام عليك زين الأنبياء السلام عليك
الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على خير خلق الله سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي وسدد لساني واهدي قلبي بحق سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما شاء الله. What a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we're able to hear from one another and learn from one another and to hear these beautiful and uplifting words that emanate from sincere hearts. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us by all that we hear and all of those around us. Everyone around us has something with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a khususiyya, a distinction that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them, and something unique. So you never know what that person has with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the intelligent believer tries to benefit from everyone and look for the good in everyone. And that's why they say regarding some of the great salihin who their righteousness was manifest. After they pass away, they would say, قَدَّسَ اللَّهُ سِرَّهُ. May Allah sanctify his secret, that special thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed within him that was then cultivated and bloomed into this beautified state with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us all that. Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Just a brief reflection aligned with everything that was said before, what our beloved brother Ridwan said and our dear Imam Suluki, of having a good opinion of Allah, having hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being connected to those who are connected to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And in reality, those meanings are the same meaning. They're connected. And what it really comes down to at a practical level in our lives is the company that we keep. It comes down on a practical level in our lives to the company that we keep. And we all know and realize that there are people whose company is good for us, and there are other people who being in their company is not good for us. And we have to make a concerted effort to be with those people who are full of light. Be with people who lift our state with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if, as Imam Suluki said, we don't think we're like them. They say, تَشَبَّهُ إِن لَمْ تَكُونُوا مِثْلَهُمْ فَإِنَّ تَشَبُّهَ الْكِرَامِ فَلَاحُ. Try to be like them, even if you're not really like them, because resembling the people of nobility is a form of success in and of itself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that the way that we make that decision is by being with those people who are on the path of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are people in the world and forces in the world and decisions that we make in our life that take us to a place that we know pollutes our soul. And sometimes it might feel good kind of in the moment, because that's the nafs, that's the lower self. It gravitates towards those things. But then deep down inside, when a person reflects, they realize that's not good for me. And there are other gatherings. And this is why someone was even saying to me earlier that when they're in an environment like this one and others like it, they feel uplifted. They're less likely to get angry and to fall into certain character traits that they don't like about themselves. So we have to be with people who are committed to being like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us of a specific man, and by extension, everyone else that comes after, who didn't follow the messenger, who didn't take him as the imam, as the exemplar, as the embodiment of all beauty and goodness and nobility, and all that is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is found in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And I remember when I was young and people would say that, I would say, oh, you know, that sounds nice. Look into it yourself. Study his life. Study his character. You will find no more beautiful and perfect human being than the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's tried and tested. Salawatullahi wa salam alayhi, which is why Muslims love him so passionately. There's no one like him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the one who combined all of the qualities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And he is the complete and perfect servant of God, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah tells us in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ويوم يعض الظالم على يديه يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا. And on that day, the day that they stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for judgment, and on that day the wrongdoer will bite his nails in regret and remorse and will say, oh, I wish I had followed the way along with the messenger. I wish I took the path that the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam was on. This was a man by the name of Uqba ibn Abi Mu'it. And he initially believed. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would be in his company. He initially believed. Then he was in the company of bad people. And one of them, Ubay ibn Khalaf, he said, you left the way of your forefathers? You left, you know, there's like an apostasy, a cultural apostasy. How dare you do that? He said, no, I just did it just to be nice to him. So he left the way of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam after that. And on the day of resurrection, he will say that. And he will say, Ya waylata layta li nam attakhid fulanan khalila. Woe to me. I wish I had never taken so-and-so as a close friend. Ubay ibn Khalaf told him, leave the way of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That the way of the Prophet, every single person on that day will see the beauty and the goodness and the life-giving nature of following the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. Respond to God and His Messenger when He calls you to that which gives you life. Everybody's alive in terms of just this very superficial form of living and breathing and consciousness, but whose heart is really alive? Whose heart is illuminated with inner sight from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who recognizes the reality of existence and knows it, that's the one who's truly alive. And one of the companions, and this goes back to what our dear brother Ridwan was saying, that this mercy and this goodness and being connected to the prophetic inheritors is not something that we want just for a select few, but that this is something that we want for as many people as humanly possible in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decree. We want it for everyone. We want everyone to be guided and everyone to taste the sweetness of iman and nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the companions, he was asked by a king, what does your prophet come with? And he said he came to take people from the worship of other created beings to worshiping the Lord of all creation. And he came to take us from the constriction of the life of this world. And all we have to do is look around us. That there are people who are abusing all types of substances just to get away from, quote unquote, reality. The constriction and the darkness of being distant from the one who created us. From the constriction of the world into what? Into the vastness and the openness of the life of this world and the hereafter. And from the wrongdoing and the injustice of things that have altered from the way of God to the uprightness and the justice of Islam. That's what he called us to, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he make us those who inherit from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That Allah makes us reflections of his beauty and his light and his beautiful character and his goodness. And that we seek out the true prophetic inheritors. And that we also help others connect to the Messenger of Allah and connect to the life-giving light that he came with, that is preserved with the inheritors. Radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Thank you for watching one of Al-Maqasid's online educational offerings. Our mission at Al-Maqasid is to cultivate holistic learning environments rooted in knowledge, devotion, and service. For more information, please visit our website at almaqasid.org and connect with other online content at almaqasid.org/connect.